That's something that many of us have been working on for 10 to 20 years. And it's phenomenal to think how far we've come. We know there's other things that have yet to be done, but that is good. I'd like to begin by calling on Scott Gianna, our state representative from the 110th District.
Very glad to be here tonight. Marquette County Dems, you're super. You're superstars. You did things across the state that people recognize statewide this last campaign, and getting out there and helping good candidates. You know that we got to do things early, you get organized, and you move ahead. And it's about action with Marquette County. And I really want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for all the support that you have given to me and part of Marquette County. Representative Kiewa, here in the county, thanks, John, for being here. It's all about the UP with us, and it's a gracious place to be from, and it's a wonderful thing to be able to represent all of you. And that would bring me tonight, I want to introduce Lon Johnson's here.
Hi, this is John.
I'm proud to call Lon a friend. And I'm glad to see that Lon has announced that he's going to run for the 1st Congressional District. And we're glad to see that you have the intelligence and the ability to be out there and choose a candidate like yourself who's going to run. And we're going to move to another part that I talked to when I first talked to you tonight. It's about action. We got to start looking at things in action. We want to start seeing people and movement now. We got a lot of things like we had the last election that are in front of us again. We got people that are in the state legislature positions. We got people in the governor's office. We got people on the federal level who want to keep working people down. Every day is a fight in Lansing and Washington, D.C. because people do not have our interests at heart. They got interests of the corporations in their heart. And that's something that I'm glad to see that Lon is having the ability tonight to be able to say he's going to run for the 1st Congressional District. And I'm here to endorse him and to support him. Because I want to see us win that seat. I want us to send a doctor back to wherever he came from. Because we need a congressman. And I appreciate the history of this district and the 1st Congressional. And that you're willing to step up tonight and say you're going to do it. Because that's what I want to see. I want to have the ability to say that we're going to have somebody that's going to send a person back to Iron County to do what he wants to do next, because we don't have somebody in our best interest. So I want to thank you all for letting me introduce Lon Johnson.
Don't win, bad things happen. And you realize when we do win, good things happen. Like Obamacare today. That decision came about because we worked and fought and elected the right people. And good things can happen when that happens. When we work together to win. Work hard, play by the rules, and never give up. Those are the lessons and values I learned from a family with 5 generations of Northern Michigan history. Those lessons guided me through a lifetime of achievement. I was one of the first in my family to graduate from college. I was in Iraq in 2005 as a civilian. I worked to invest in and grow U.S. manufacturing companies. And those are the values and traditions I'm going to take when I go to Congress. We've got to work to do 3 things. We've got to, 1, work to create a UP and a Northern Michigan that can remain place where we can stay, succeed, not lose our children and our grandchildren downstate. We've got to work to create and keep Northern Michigan and the UP both beautiful and profitable. We can strike that balance. And last but not least, we've got to create a government that's every bit as hardworking and honest as the people who pay for it. We can do all those things. To do that, we need to invest in and protect our greatest assets, our people, our land, and our great lakes. And that's why today I'm announcing my candidacy for the first congressional district for the state of Michigan. Long, hard, expensive fight. We can do this. We can win. The time for hopes and wishes and maybes are over. The stakes are too high. We've got to start right now. And together, we can do this. Let's go to work and let's go win. Thank you.
Last time I worked the phone banks for the first congressional, the people I talked to who wound up voting against us were angry. Yep. They were afraid, and was they are overwhelmingly so. How can we overcome that?
They're afraid because they're being told by the other side a pack of lies.
Truly.
We're not answering back. Yep. We're not showing them precisely what they will get when they vote for a Democratic candidate. We have to be bold and we have to be detailed to show them precisely what they will get if Democrats are given the privilege of governing. We cannot run away, but we also have to go out there and make that case.
Yep.
To do that, it takes you and it takes a campaign that has a strategy and has the ability to execute.
You got my vote, sir.
Thank you. Two things, and that's why I'm standing right here, right now, a year and a half out, announcing for this position. Second, we are not going to wait and say, well, let's, what does the pollster say? What does some folks in Washington say? We know the issues. We need to go out there and tell the voters precisely what we think, and we cannot wait until next year or October. We have to start right now and be bold and in detail and show the voters precisely how we will create a UP in Northern Michigan that they will stay and succeed.
The other problem is
when the other side keeps spewing lies,
we cannot
act accordingly by refusing. That's what happens. Well, that takes manpower and volunteer hours. That takes issues that are clear and concise to the voters, and that takes resources. And every one of those things I can bring to this campaign. I want to talk about it as far as bold and detailed things. We should be talking about passenger rail fares. We should be talking about high-speed energy. We should not run for the track. We need to be bold and detailed and talk about who we are and lean into our values. Not run.
I'm a veteran, and one of the things when veterans get together, we talk about how totally disappointed we are in the care of Dr. Hickson and his lip service without any action. How do we deal with the veterans and all the issues they have out there?
Let me answer broadly, and then Dylan's down into the veterans. So, look, Benishak has made a lot of promises in this country. He's made a ton of promises. And every one of those promises are empty or have been broken. He said he was going to protect seniors. And what does he do? He voted for a Republican budget that makes the Medicare into a voucher program. He said he's going to protect workers. What did he do last week? He voted to fast track a take trade deal that's worse than that. So he sent thousands of our jobs overseas. And as far as the veterans, what he did, he because he's hiding behind veterans and say, well, that's the reason why I'm going to break my pledge to serve only 2 terms to protect our veterans. Meanwhile, he's voted against increased funding for This guy's talking out of both sides of his mouth. He's broken every single promise, and he said he's only going to serve 3 terms out of my 4. Let's just give him 3 terms and make him keep his promise.
Oh, there's the
no matter where you're at, whether you're here this meeting or you're Sue or you're down in Grayling or you're over now, everyone has one really question for us. How do we stay in Northern Michigan or the UT and succeed? That's really the question.
It's so loud they can't hear it. Because they had formerly, the commander wasn't there.
We have to answer that very clearly to the voters. These aren't Democrat or Republican ideas. This is how
his mom likes
every place
so
wants to stay in the seat. It's ideas like college roll tail, high speed internet, passenger rail service, ideas like water, Northern Michigan. So that we should come to work thoughtfully on the use of the fresh water. You know, by excellent geography, we have 29% of the world's fresh water right here in Michigan. We have a competitive advantage over every other state, and every other world. How are we taking advantage of that? The Silicon Valley is the Silicon Valley water. Because Stanford University got funding. Same with the research finance, North Carolina, same with Louisiana, in Texas. We need to create a water institute right here in Northern Michigan to show the world how to use the fresh water, because if we don't, two things are going to happen. Somebody else is going to do it, and they're going to make a job. And if we don't, they're going to be here for our water. There's a goal and a detailed answer.
Thank you. not going to bore you with an introduction, you know who I am, where I'm from, what I've done, what I can do. And so, really, my decision about running again is really about conversations that we're going to start having tonight that I've had already. So, I would not make this decision on my own without consulting. It's presumption. So I want to make sure, when I do something, we're in to win. And so I want to make sure that we've got the commitment and resources and the energy and the organization. And that's what I'm doing right now. So we'll talk about that. Kind of deja vu for me. 2 years ago, when I was in this exploratory stage, Liz and I attended our first public event. You know where it was? Right here. And Lizzie would be there with me tonight, but we're both recovering from some kind of crush. And I think I must have had it first because I am better. But if I lose my voice, you know what that's all about. But it's great to be back in Marquette. It's great to see you. It's been a long 6-7 months. And we've been doing a lot of thinking, a lot of talking, and a lot of trying to figure out what we're going to do. I got to tell you, and Scott already alluded to it, you guys are phenomenal. You did great. Matter of fact, I voted for my friend, John Kiko, out of the Ohio Democratic vote getter. So that's a testament to you, not me. You guys work hard. I appreciate it. All I can say is thank you, thank you, thank you. Our kids leading the way, it's always led the way, it's continuing to lead. Let's go back to 2013. I was recruited and encouraged and characterized by a lot of people that we know and that we trust and we admire, as, and Lon was one of these, to be a candidate for the Michigan State Congressional Group. That I was the best candidate. And I came to believe that. And I worked hard. A lot of people were like invested and interested and excited. And I came to believe that then,